Hello, and welcome to the production guide with MSPM0. In this video, I'm going to introduce you to the guidelines of MSPM0 production programming. First, let's look at the different ways to program MSPM0. When code debugging is completed, you can generate production image files such as a .bin, .txt, or .hex files. One way to program is to use ARM Serial Wire Debug, or SWD. SWD uses interface communication lines called SWDIO and SWClock. To program with SWD, you need a hardware bridge and the corresponding software. The most common programming for single devices is the XDS110 and UniFlash software. For mass programming, the MSP-GANG and the MSP-GANG GUI. Popular third-party programmers include the Sager J-Link and automated IC programmers. In addition to the SWD interface, the Bootstrap loader interface can also be used for programming. BSL is the on-chip bootloader, which is a program that loads the boot program stored in the ROM area of the chip. The communication interfaces used for BSL programming are some common communication interfaces, such as UART and I2C. The hardware tools and software support for BSL are shown in the figure. The hardware bridge requirement from computer to MCU is a USB to UART, or I2C. The host computer will then send instructions according to the BSL protocol. If needed, a secondary BSL can be created to use other communication interfaces or functions. For further information, please see the MSPM0 Bootloader's User's Guide. The following is a further explanation of the programming methods offered by TI. First, UniFlash works with XDS110 or third-party J-Link to program the MSPM0 via SWD or BSL. UniFlash can support Windows, macOS, or Linux. In addition to the graphical user interface, UniFlash also supports command line mode, where customers can develop their own graphical interface based on the command line mode or facilitate Linux system or script calls. UniFlash can also read memory data or manual data checking for debugging. Refer to the Quick Start Guide for additional details. The second recommended TI tool is MSP-GANG, which has more programming capabilities than UniFlash in addition to the support for online programming and command line modes. It also has the following two functions. One, the MSP-GANG can program 1 to 8 devices in parallel or can manually enable or disable each channel. Two, MSP-GANG supports offline programming and can store image files so programs can be flashed to the MSPM0 without a host machine. Let's take MSP-GANG as an example to show you the process of flashing a program. The first step is to establish a hardware connection where the SWD interface is used, which requires 5 wires, 2 SWD signal wires, 1 reset wire, a power, and ground. The second step is to configure the MSPM0 GANG software GUI. First, select the interactive mode and select the device. Then configure memory. Here is the configuration needs to read and write flash. Then configure the power mode. If the MSP-GANG power is selected, please note that the current load is limited to 50 milliamps. This routine uses an external power supply. Then we'll configure the security option, which is the configuration of non-main flash. Here, select default. Select the image file you want to burn. The third step is to flash the file. Select the channel you want to program, and then click the Go button to finish programming. Here's a little bit more to add about how to generate an image file in CCS. Right-click your project and go to Project Properties. Under the Build, go to ARM Hex Utility, enable the ARM Hex Utility, then go to Output Format Options and select the output of your choosing. Thanks for watching this video. Please check these links out to access additional information about MSPM0. Thanks!